Hello guys, Hugo here, hope you're well. Welcome back to another P3D video. Yes, P3D, not Microsoft Flight Sim. You've had two videos already. I think I spoiled you enough with the gorgeous looking Microsoft Flight Sim. And we're back in P3D at Freeware at Istanbul. The reason why I say Freeware is just because it looks horrendous compared to what Microsoft Flight Sim can do with default. But anyway, yeah, so we're at the new Istanbul airport. This is Freeware scenery from Turkish Virtual. And we're flying off to Mauritius. We're using the FSDG Mauritius scenery for that. Flight time just about 9 hours long. We're taking it, or taking the passengers there with the Airbus A330 made by Aerosoft. Lovely. Look at that. There's an aircraft departing as you speak. Awesome. So, let's go inside the cockpit and let's get things set up. Okay, here we are. I need to remember how to use the Aerosoft. I haven't flown the A330 in a long time. I know load fuel and then load sheet. That brings the load sheet that I created using the fuel planner. So you can see, zero fuel weight of, yeah, here we go. 160.9 tons. The CG31.7, which gives us a trim of up 2.2 for our departure today. And I believe, yeah, fuel, here we go, 63.1 tons as well. I can actually use the GSX fueling, but I won't today because that takes forever. So what I'm going to do is just going to request boarding here. Boarding requested, and it should say 263. Yes, awesome. And Turkish Airlines, please. Go to the top left there. Awesome. So that will start. So fuel starting, the boarding will actually begin once the jetway gets connected up. It should ask me for the jetway. Is it going to connect to Stan? What? Is there a belt for the forward cargo door? That's very weird. And then there's that, which is fine. Okay. Okie dokie, let's get some power. So external power on, and batteries on. Let's get the dome light up and running so we can get that on. No, that doesn't really do anything because we've got dynamic lighting. So we need to get the intake lights up and running for up here. But where are they? I think it's just this. It just has all of them. Yes, awesome. So, IRSs, nav. Fuel pumps, actually they'll stay off. Yeah, so MSX lights can get armed. Seatbelts on. And, actually no, off. We'll still be fueling. And that can stay off too. Nav logo light to 1. And, what else on the overhead? Anything else? Awesome. Okay, so, FM1, FM2, flight plan. And yeah, let's go and get these on like so. Init page. I don't know if init request is a thing. No, I think company boots though. So LT, I think it's like a 01 as well at the end. So LTFM and then FIMP for Mauritius. And 01, I believe, fingers crossed, it does say please wait. This is the way of getting it. Seems so. Right, so we're flying as Turkish. I think it's 160? Yeah, 160. And apparently Simbrief, I don't know what the cost index is for Turkish Airlines, so Simbrief gave me 116. Pretty high, but whatever. We're going to be cruising at flight level 350, so 35,000 feet at its high. We can go and request the winds. And actually, we can set that up once we've finished boarding and fuel and everything like that. Wind data uplink. Oh, so that's done already? Nice. Yeah, I'm not too sure on what it's thinking about the jetway. I can't bring up the GSX menu, which is really odd. What's it saying down here? So fueling is going. There's no cargo loaded on. But I'm assuming that's just because the The belt isn't, not the belt. The actual pallets aren't here yet. No idea. Maybe GSX recognizes that I'm fueling and doesn't want to connect up the jetway until the fueling has completed. Interesting. That could be the reason. I might be wrong on that though. I might be wrong. We'll see. IRS alignment in 4 minutes. Actually, I don't think it should, because I think I remember it boarding and fueling at the same time. So I don't know why it's broken like that. I could just click load instant and that'll fix it up. Because GSX is not responding. I think it's crashed. Restart. Cool. Let's see how this works. That's now done, but the problem is these are all flashing. Waiting for GSX is my guess. So I did load instant. Here we go. They've all stopped flashing. Nothing's going. Yeah, all jetways stopped to main module. So it did crash. And I've got a load sheet for our weights and everything, which is nice. So if we go over to here and we go to 0 fuel weight, we can see 160.9. And then our CG, 31.7. And then our block fuel is 63.1. Like so. Flight plan 35 right, and Istanbul 1 hour for departure. I believe that is correct. Let me just quickly grab my SimBrief charts and just have a quick look to make sure. Yes, that is correct. Awesome. And there's no discontinuities, is there? No. Cool. That can go away. There we go. And we can go to the perf page. And I guess we can request pushback. Let's get the APU started up. So long how GSX didn't work just then. Actually, I can stay on off. I'll get the APU started up. Beacon light can go on so people on the ground know that I'm ready to go. All the fuel pumps on to auto. And yeah. Pepper push back. Turkish Airlines. Yes. Really annoying how that glitched out earlier. Hey ho. I forgot how I calculated. Why is that flashing? I forgot how I calculated the departures of the A330. Because I know you can just click them. Or not. Maybe you can't click them. How did I calculate the A330? Okay, I found a calculator to calculate the flex using flap 1, which gives us flex 42. Does that now give us V-speeds? I swear it's... Oh, flap 1. Ah, there we go. Now it gives us V-speeds. Lovely. Right, let's go and tell GSX we want to go... was it nose left or nose right? Nose... let's go nose right. APU bleed on, external power off, and then we need to go and set up the MCP quickly. So, Istanbul 1 hour for arrival, departure. I mean, initial climb is 8,000. Click that in. Flight director's up and running. QNH is 1011, like that, I believe that's set up. Actually, the VOR is already on. I can get to airport. Constraints 20 terrain on that side. And. Ah, yes, we need to go down to here. We need to go to ground services and turn that off. GSX pushback. Yes. Bypass bin inserted. Okay. Release parking brake. So GSX is ready for pushback. Let's just go and monitor the situation around the airport. It seems to be clear for us to push, so. Make sure IRS is finished, which they are, so release the parking brake. Awesome! So we've got the big light on, we've got the APU bleed, which gives us the air for the engine start. That can stay off for now, that's fine. So we are good for engine start. Let's go and start the timer. Where is it? There we go. Run, ignition start. That's already pressurized, so engine start number 2. There we are. So number two is now starting up. What is it? The wing view here. And watch it power itself up. Yeah, you can see here, it's this BA and this Turkish A330, like basically inside each other. It's because there's like, I forget to tell you here, you can see there's three SAMs, and they're all in the aft cabs, rather through left, the center, and the right, all in the aft cabs. And so AI doesn't really care about positioning into other aircraft, so it can spawn three aircraft in one stand, which is pretty odd looking. There's two there, like I said, the BA and the Turkish. Yeah. That's why that looks like that. Anyway, engine number two started up pretty nicely, so start number one. It's getting a bit dim in here now. I don't have the lighting from the terminals light us up, so let's bring up some lights there. And on the it's not MCP, is it? It's the FCU or something like that. FCP? I can't remember. For the Airbus. Anyway. Engine number one is starting up now. Awesome. Right, pushback should end soon. There we are. So, parking brake is set. Is that locked? Is that properly locked? There we go. And I might get a lag spike every now and then. Let's just auto-save. Some reason when you save the Airbus, or the Aerosoft even, the auto saves just lag it out because it needs to save a ton of data. Anyway, right. Engine started up and that's all good to bail. So that can go back to normal. APU can go off. And yes, so flight control. That's the fuel page. Flight control page. Here we go. Let's do our flight control check. So full left, full right. All the way down, all the way up, that's good. Rudder full left, please set parking brake immediately. Rudder full right, and we need to trim up to 2.2, it's just one off there, so there we go, 2.2, flap one, transport is armed, click off that page, there we are, and yeah, awesome. Just waiting for GSX to get out of the way. We're good to go. We're setting max auto brake there. I don't think it's like the flight sim labs, so I have to push that down. I think the rudder and tiller is in the same axis in this current setting. We'll see once we get taxiing. Taxi's really simple. 35 right is actually not too far from where we are at the moment. We just need to taxi forward and we'll take a right at Echo 8. Which is there, and we continue down Echo 8, literally taxi down straight, and we'll get ourselves to the runway. Awesome, let's go and get ourselves going. So taxi light on, turn offs on, and there we are, we're moving already on idle. So signs on, that's fine, takeoff config is normal, so just cabin needs to be checked, and as soon as we get that no portable electronic devices ticked, we can should have an ECAM no blue. There we go. I don't know how to check the cabin. Is that a thing it just does automatically? That is my guess. It is. Ding Dong might have done it. Awesome. So yeah, we should get to a hold short, a Charlie 1 Alpha, that's 1 Bravo. Charlie 1 Alpha, 3-5 right, yes, awesome. Here we go, cabin is ready. Lovely. Did that light, that building just all just light up just then? Right. I just realised it looks like CIA when you zoomed out a bit. Can't see the one, so it looks like a straight line. CIA. Awesome. So, everything's good for takeoff. ECAM no blue. sort of standby and predict when she was off for now. I know, let's actually go and get the weather radar on now. And predict wind shear is on auto, and T gas to auto, and TAI at squawking 2000 IFR. Land the lights can go on, take off light on the nose. If I can click it the right way, strobe light can go on. Awesome, that's all our lights up and running for takeoff. Let's do the full right turn here, get ourselves lined up, 3-5 right, verified. Okay, let's get out of here. So we're gonna go flex today. We'll just pitch down a bit. I need to take a look down at the throttle because I don't know where the flex indent is. There we are. Man flex, SRS, runway, autothrust blue, starting the timer. But then over on the A330, you pitch down like the Airbus A320 family. So I'm just gonna actually just keep it straight like that. Awesome. So there we go, airspeed is alive. AC knots. Let's have a quick wing view back at the terminal. Lovely. Because of how long the runway is. Big flex, D-ray even. V1, rotate. 50 seconds at rotation, nice. Don't pitch up too high until you're actually off the ground. There we are. Positive climb, gear up. Gear's coming up. Then all these lights should just go out once the gear is up and locked. There we are, gears up. Nice steady climb. And I think about 2,000, 1,500 feet, we should set climb thrust, acceleration attitude. Yeah, I can't remember. We'll see. Flying manually for now. There we go, climb thrust. Thrust climb, set. Here's our acceleration altitude to get the autopilot on for this. And up to our cruising altitude of, I've forgotten, 350. And no restrictions, so all the way up. Optimum climb, or open climb even. And we've gone past the S speed, so we can bring the flaps up. Ground spoilers can disarm. And there we are. No port electronic devices can go back off. So we can set this up a bit higher range. Like that. Awesome. I think I've turned up the sim volume than I typically have, so if this is a good volume for you guys, just let me know. If it's a bad volume, let me know. If it's a good volume, then go yay, you love this video. Because it's kind of hard to decide, really. Lovely. Ah, I've forgotten the transition attitude here in Istanbul. It's 12,000 feet, so 12,000 we'll set standard pressure. At 10,000 feet before that, we'll set the land lights to off. In fact, that nose light can go off because, well, the gear's up, so we're not going to get any nose lights. There's the flight plan page in there. Lovely. So, there's our first left-hand turn to get us towards Mauritius, facing south. We should be arriving in about 9 hours' time. I should have used the EFB, but, like, it's a bit meh, a bit too detailed as well. Zen after climb, yeah, when positive climb, put up, gear up, and all that stuff. I should have done all that, but meh. Oh well. She is my charts on Navigraph? Apparently not. Okie dokie. I didn't set that yet. This is a really wide turn. Like, really wide. Interesting. Is that like a glitch? Is that just the name? Is that a zero? It looks pretty weird there. Okay. Actually, no. I think it's saying this 0.13 left or something like that. Yeah. It's not like a tiny little circle on the ND. Cool. So yeah, it's really dark here. I mean, it is what 2:30 a.m. Istanbul time. So we'll be landing in the day in Mauritius, which is lovely. What's this announcement? We are climbing to our cruise level. I've been cruising since takeoff. Climbing to cruise since takeoff. 9,000, so 1,000 to go for our landing lights to turn off. Well, to go off. Well, yeah, they will turn off. But they will turn off from us switching off. That's not automatic. How cool that would be? Automatic lights, but if everything becomes automatic, then things just become boring. So, why would you do that? So, 10,000 feet, basically, more or less. So, lander light can go off, turn off can go off, lag spike from the autosave. There we go. Turn offs is off, lander lights are off, nose lander lights are off, and the strobe, the beacon, and the nav lights can stay on like that, which is set. So we passed 10,000 feet, which means we will now accelerate to our climb speed. So today it will be 320 knots, indicated that is. Oh, there's an aircraft over there climbing. Must have departed at Istanbul as well. Awesome. What a view that is. The runway lights and then the black marble night lighting. Look at it extend into the city. That looks amazing. Absolutely amazing. Looks so nice. Oh, zooming in out, like the lighting changes. Okay. So gorgeous. Right, there we are, 320 knots and almost at our transition altitude of 12,000 feet. So yeah, so 320 knot indicated and passing almost 390 ground speed. Are we going to have a tailwind at our cruise altitude? I think so. Yeah, let's see. I was looking at my flight plan, and no, we won't. Apparently we won't. Okay, standard pressure. That's the wrong button. There we go, and there we are. Standard set. Wow. I hope you guys have enjoyed our departure out of Istanbul, the new airport, and I will see you in the arrival back into Mauritius. Not back into, just into Mauritius in about 9 hours' time. And enjoy the cinematics of the beautiful Aerosoft A330, and bye-bye. Hello guys, welcome back into the descent into Mauritius. Sorry for coming back so late into descent. My OBS decided to crash. Very unfortunate, but I had to restart it. And that didn't work, so I had to restart the PC, and now I'm back. So we've come back a bit late, 13,000 feet into the descent. And I believe, isn't it? No. I thought 13,000 feet was the transition altitude. It is not. I've flown to Mauritius so many times, how do I still not know? It's 4,000 feet. It even says it in the Airbus. There you go. 4,000 feet. So, what we need to go and do is set up the QNH temperature and wind data at Mauritius, which is currently QNH 1021. It's 24 degrees. Winds are 120 at 14 knots. Config full. We're landing on the runway 14. We're taking the ILS to 14, and the minimums will be 446 feet, like that. We're currently on the bank. What are we on? Gap Key 1 out arrival. Gap Key 1, and that actually just one waypoint which transitions into the ILS for 14 via Gap Key. Which takes us, as you can tell, S-Pier, and then transitions us on to 14 ILS. I'm just going to be passing 10,000 feet at the moment, so we're going to be slowing down. I've got some sea break, as you can tell. And oh, I just realised the VNAV just jumped super high for some reason. That's weird. I'm going to set that to 4,000 feet. That is where we will go and hopefully capture the ILS by. And yeah, I'm not too sure why the VNAV just jumped up super high. I guess Aerosoft is being an Aerosoft. There you go, there's the island loading in there. I was just laughing because I'm zoomed in so much that the waypoint's like not matched up with the actual like, terrain scan that it previously had. Looked a bit weird. We're going to be landing on the sea. Yeah, no. Zoom in on these displays a bit better. So we're back at the speed. VNAV's caught up, passing 10,000 feet. Analytics can go on. Actually, yeah, because all that stuff I was messing about with OBS, I forgot to turn these seatbelt signs on. So let's go and do that now. Hopefully, these passengers can get themselves sat quickly as possible. I mean, it's at 10,000 feet, we've still got like 5 minutes left of the flight, and actually, speaking of flight time, 8 hours and 46 into the flight, so we're going to be landing a bit earlier than expected, which is always a lovely thing. Passengers can get to the destination earlier, which is lovely. We're now flying in the clouds, yay! What's up with that like big circle there? There's nothing wrong with the flight plan, is there? No. I guess it thinks it needs to do a really tight turn. Okie dokie. So we've got the land system like that, and you can tell is IPL the correct VOR? It is not. We are looking for PLS, which is actually on VOR1. We just need to wait until we get a bit closer to the airport, and then we'll go to PLS, and I'll give us an accurate DME for the runway. Hopefully. I see. So yeah, 4,000 feet transition, that's also when we should be on the localizer, the ILS even. And everything literally happens at 4,000 feet. I'll probably bring out some flaps as well by then. Or not before, if not before even. There's 8,000 feet. If I look at Atlas Sky, is there... Yeah, apparently clouds broken all the way up down to 1,700 feet, so yeah, we got clouds for a while, a long time. Maybe, wait, let me just double check, is it IPL or PLS? Oh no, it is IPL, I lied. PLS is literally another VOR, which is right next to it, a localizer. Anyway, extends to speed rake. I mean, we're like just about to go below the glide, so it doesn't really matter, but okay, sure thing. Right, so yeah, we're 21 nautical miles from the runway then. once we get about 15, I'll start thinking about flat one. You can see flat one, we're looking for 240 knots. Anything lower, then we can bring out the flap. You can tell the double dashed line there. So that means we're actually on the bridge, if that's correct. And yeah, there we go. So we're below the guide slope, that's fine. I bring out some more speed rig because we do not want to go too fast, because otherwise we'll never decelerate, which would be a bad thing. We should decelerate pretty quickly at this waypoint here, because we'll be sticking at 4,000 feet, and it'll give us time to decelerate to a said speed. Not too sure what I should do then. Maybe I'll go green dot, I don't know. So like, what, like 210-ish? We'll go 210 when we reach 4,000. Let's make sure, just double check when we get to the DME there and see what the best idea is there. Approach phase has just been activated, that's okay. We'll go 240. And we're just approaching 4,000 as well. Awesome. So we should be catching that localizer anytime soon. And then the glide slope should be captured just after the waypoint Bigra. Just after. And here we are, approaching 4,000 feet. And out hold, basically. Lovely. We will slow down to the green dot. I don't know if the airsoft has been coded to once it reaches the green dot. I don't know if it's been coded to stay at the green dot. If you've got no flaps out, the aircraft, if anything selected lower, it will go down to the green dot, and it won't go slower because of like dangerous speeds, basically. So it should do that. It might not, because I mean, it is aerosoft. I'm not putting them down, I'm just saying they're not as detailed as, let's say, flight synapse. So here we are at the localizer. So it should increase some thrust now. Which it's not. So, we'll just do this. 206. Actually, once we hit 12 miles, I will set 180 knots. It's going to set flaps 1. Just let the aircraft not be a bit too slow there. Awesome. And there's the glide slope. Lovely. So let's go 180 knots now, actually. So the aircraft's just going to power right down again. And there's 4,000. So, sound of pressure, can go off, and we'll set the current gainage. 1021. One. Okay. 021. 1021, 1021. Okay, lovely. Let's double check if that hasn't changed. Nope, we're good. Not too sure why our speed's so high. Let's bring out some speed brake. Lovely. Keep us slowing down. I know the speed brake's still out, but I'm not at the current speed yet, so why are you moaning? Come on. Okay, flap 2. Oi! Stop it. Thank you. I'll bring out max speed brake because I'm not too sure why. I haven't looked at the speed. The wind. See if the wind is causing the aircraft to speed up randomly. And then we get like a 160 approach speed just to make it a bit nicer. Less close to that overspeed tape. Better. 8 miles now from the runway. At 1,700 feet, we should see the runway. Fingers crossed. If not, we'll be doing an autoland. Let's kick in this.
1,000.
And wow, that was super loud. Nice cool outs. Scared me. It's not actually 1,000 feet above the runway altitude. We're like descending, like down a hill, which is a bit confusing if you don't understand. All the flaps, please. So the gear being down and all the flaps coming out, we should have enough drag, and I'll set low auto brake as well. So landing checklist is all complete. Landing gear down, stands are on, cabinet ready, spoilers arm, flaps full, landing lights are on, and auto brake is low. And I can just start to see some of the ground. It's been a while since the last landed to the A330. If you don't know the Aerosoft A330, then it's a bit weird in terms of, let's say, flight model. I don't know if they tried to make it realistic, but it's very sludgy, let's say. At least it doesn't bounce on the landing like the black box. Right, let's take out the autopilot, my aircraft. See the whole runway, everything's all clear. There we go. Whoa, that wind. Ah, nice. Not to save, as we're at
400
feet above the ground. Nice. Speed is getting very close there. Wow, yeah. I'm trying to get used to this feel, this aircraft. I feel like it's very delayed and lagged.
300.
Like the controls will be smoothed out. But it could be the way this aircraft flies. I mean, it is really big and sluggish, so. Just don't want to overturn there, because that's when things become bad.
100 above. 200.
Keep a line at the runway. And on the glass, so minimum, continue.
Flight slow.
100.
Flight slow. Descent too fast.
50.
Flight slow.
40. 30. 20. Retard.
Idle throttle.
Retard.
Flare.
5.
Touchdown. Versus green. Decel. Let's get back on the center line. And we made it. That wasn't as bad as I thought it would have turned out to be. Awesome. 80 knots. Forward idle. 60 knots. Manual braking. And right, okay. I do never miss clicking the window and not opening mid-flight, and I wonder if it's only just opened it now because now the pressure's fine. Right, let's just keep the airspeed pretty high because I'm going to vacate over there. Right, there we go. 8 hours and 56 minutes on the dot where the radar can go off. Ground support is disarmed, flaps up, and here we are vacating at Delta. Nice. Landing rate was -131, for those of you who want to know. Turn off the landing system there. Put on some brakes. Bit more, get ourselves down to 10 knots ground speed. Anything higher, it's too fast for a turn. There we go. Right round we go. Awesome. Right. As I make this second right turn, I'm going to check on flight radar to see if there's a preferred stand to park at for Turkish Airlines. T-Gas can go to standby. Rest of it, there we go. And we can get the APU started up, so we'll just get APU start on, and all these lights can go, obviously, taxi light on. Oh, am I going over? No, I'm not, good. And taxi blind, awesome. APU can start up, so we've just got the taxi light, we can like stay on, that's awesome. So, flight radar. Is it possible you can tell me where we park? It is. Okay. Stand number 8. 8 it is. Too small. No, we will not say that's too small. It'll be fine. Is that a shell? BP. It's BP. Shell's a shell. That's BP. Shell's the red and yellow sign, isn't it? YJ Lounge. I thought it was a YU. U Lounge. So I've been here IRL, I can't remember. It's been a while since the last flight to Mauritius. So yeah, stand number 8 is actually just over there at the old terminal. Which actually, yeah, it's renovated now. Which is really nice, but yeah. Stand number 8 is over there. At the old terminal. So that's this hotel on the left there. Hotel intersection. We'll take a left at Golf. And then we'll just turn right a little bit. And then stand number 8 will be on our left. Awesome. There's like 2 control towers at this airport. I'm not too sure why. And I'm not too sure if like one was used and the taller one now is now used because it's taller and you can see more of the airport. Right, we don't need any lights on anymore. Round we go. But I'm turning way too fast. Slow down, please. Okay. Yeah, I don't know why. Very odd. Cause it's not default P3D controls now, so I wouldn't think it's a an exclusion problem. Right, and spin it around. We had that SOD error when we departed Istanbul. I wonder if these jetways are still going to work. That's a terrible lineup, Hugo. Still to the right? There we go. Awesome. This guy seems to be way off. I'll stop on the yellow dot. There we go. Awesome. Right, parking brake is a set. There we go. And APU's running. Engines, good night. APU bleed can go on. And seatbelt signs can go off. No smoking. No. Portable electronic devices, even. That can go off. We'll flush the flight directors. And request deboarding. Okay, the jetway is working. Nice. Beacon light can go off. And we can go down here. We can go to ground services and external power and traffic cones and wheel chocks. That can go off now because we've got wheel chocks and external power can go on and APU can turn off like that. There we are. And there's a weird audio glitch that you now have for some reason. Anyway, there we are. Stand number 8 in Mauritius. Hope you guys enjoyed our lovely Airbus A330 flight with Turkish Airlines. I think we've done we did a Turkish Airlines 787 flight recently. Well, I say recently, but like one of the recent videos. We did it to that from the freeway scenery and to some other airport. I can't quite remember. But yeah, we're back with Turkish Airlines, which is nice. I kind of like their fleet, 787s, 8030s, 777s, and so on. Good fleet. And yeah, we took the A330 down to Mauritius, that was lovely. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I will see you in the next one, and give this video a lovely big thumbs up, and a subscribe if you haven't done so yet. Greatly appreciated, and there's the passengers coming off the aircraft. Nice. So, thank you guys very much for watching today's video. I'll see you in the next one, and bye-bye for now.